Hi guys, hi guys. Hope you're doing well. This is been to Forex. I just want to show you guys how we are prepared for this coming week. Last week, we just took a trade on like Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. It was a beautiful, profitable days. But Thursday and Friday, we did not take a trade. On Wednesday, we missed that buying opportunity on US 30. Let me show you guys. Yeah, we missed this movement. So we missed this movement. So I got so angry when I missed this movement, because I wanted to, if you guys saw my previous last week video, you saw that we're looking to go long. So I missed on the first day, I missed that this movement, and I was so angry myself, like, yeah. But yeah, so right now, there's no way for you to start to look for sell opportunity on US 30, US 30. Maybe by this time it's going high, you know, maybe, unless it's gonna range somewhere there before continuing up. Yeah, for now, we won't expect US 30 to fall anytime now. So maybe it's, for this time, it's gonna break this high, the highest high, yeah. But for me, I'll just be looking to go long. For now, I won't be looking to go short on US 30. So so this week I'll be focusing, my main focus is gonna be on Nasdaq, because Nasdaq is also going to do the same movement this week, the way US30 did. So now I'll be just focusing, because even US30 is already almost at the end for those last profit. But if I see a small drop from this zone where it is, maybe if it goes up and then fall, then I'll be looking to go long here. So for now, there's no way you have to look for sell opportunity on US30. So my main concern here is is Nasdaq. So this is DXY. I don't trade DXY. Actually, all I do on DXY, I just analyze to see how the dollar index do. So if you see here, dollar index is gonna go up a bit before falling down. Yeah. So Nasdaq. Right now, Nasdaq is it was like correcting here. So now we're expecting Nasdaq to go. So I think if Nasdaq make a bit of a retracement down, maybe down, then I'll be looking to buy from these zones. However, if it breaks this zone, then I'll consider this one. So Nasdaq, this week I'll be looking to go long on Nasdaq. No matter what, Nasdaq has to give me those profit, because I already missed the opportunity on Thursday on US 30. And then, yeah, but now I don't want Nasdaq to do the same, to leave me. Maybe today midnight when the market will open, maybe if I don't oversleep, then I'll wake up so that I can place my position, my buying position. Because right now, there's no way Nasdaq is going to fall again or to come down again. So I'll make sure that I keep track on Nasdaq. But tomorrow, if I wake up and then I see that Nasdaq did not yet leave me, because I know maybe when the market open, it's when it will start shooting up. But no matter what, I'll be looking to buy on Nasdaq. If I just see price doesn't come again near down, just break this zone near, then I won't mind about the session. I'll just jump in and yeah, go with the market, because I this week Nasdaq must pay. Yeah, Nasdaq has to pay this week. And you guys, you can see now market is no longer doing lower low, lower high, or lower high, lower low. Now it's trying to do like just with a low, lower low, doing higher high, higher low. So if it comes down, then it's gonna create a higher high, and then it's gonna create a low. We're going to look for that higher low before going up. So if price start dropping from here, my focus is gonna be, if I maybe put my Fibonacci here, if I put my Fibonacci here, let's say if it start dropping from somewhere here, and then this zone here, this between the 50% and 61% is where I'm going to look my buying position. But if it doesn't, we're just going to say that, okay, this was the first impulse, this correction, then maybe it's gonna go up, and then it's gonna create that higher high, and then we'll come and create a higher low before proceeding up. But just remember that we are bullish on NASDAQ. We are bullish on NASDAQ. And for those people that like trading pattern, like head and shoulder things, you can see that where's that head and shoulder? If you make it like this, the inverted head and shoulder, like this, this is the head. Maybe until here, then from there, maybe is when it maybe comes down before proceeding up. We don't know, but this is just not a way to look the market. So what I think, this market may not even come again here, it may just break. If it just break this zone here, then I'll buy from somewhere there, then I'll put my stop loss below this supply zone. So then, then I'll hold it. I don't know. Then I'll hold it. So guys, today I don't have like much to say. Yeah, because everything is already analyzed here. So remember the market. This was the impulse. Market was a downtrend, but then it failed to create a new lower low. So now we see that the market is shifting. So now we see that the market is starting to be bullish market. So I just want to see market break. I know that this supply zone won't hold, because now the market is trying to do higher low. So higher low. So then we know that this supply zone won't hold, so it's gonna be violated. So we will be looking to go long on NASDAQ, so that doesn't leave us again the way US Fed did last week. So guys, if you see, it's almost the same structure. If you guys can see what's happening on NASDAQ and US Fed, can you guys see this correction here? This was the impulse. It's the correction, impulse. We need a correction, even a small correction before continuation. This is the same thing that happened here. As you can see, this was a correction, impulse, correction, impulse, correction, impulse. So the next correction on NASDAQ, maybe it's gonna start from here, from the high. It might start from the high after breaking this high. Maybe after breaking this high, maybe it's when it's gonna, after breaking this high, it's when we will see a correction. Or maybe even it doesn't break the high, maybe just see the high to create a double bottom, a double top. and then it will start correcting before continuing up. Yeah, there will be a correction before the market will break up again. There will be a big correction. We don't know if it's going to be a big correction, but as we know, that was an impulse correction, then we need to see another correction, and then to see another big impulse to the upside. Yeah, so for now, as I said, I will just put my eye on Nasdaq for this week, because there is where the money will be there. Our bias is like, okay, our bias is like flowing well. So yeah, because guys, remember, if this was supposed to continue going down, this market from here was not supposed to return, was supposed to proceed down to create a new lower low, but it did not. That is a sign that the market want to shift. So now, and we've seen that we have broken that lower low that was broken before. You see, we broke it, then we created this high. Yeah, we created, you see, this was supposed to be a lower high, but it's not a lower because they not break this structure. So now we are expecting the market to continue going up. So the reason last week the market did not like break is because of this strong supply zone, but it won't hold. It won't hold. And if you see the same, if you see here, the market is just doing the same thing as here. Did like, then it went up. And when it went up, it was correcting. The same way it was doing it, then it went down, then it was correcting. That's the same thing it did here. Now, after doing that correction, it went up. So now, after it went up, so the same also here. Correction, it went up. So we are going to expect another correction. This small correction here, it's almost like this one. Almost, but this is a small correction. So we're expecting for the market to go. I don't think this market will come again down here. So I'll just look like this. I'll just look this market like that. So this is a correction. This is a correction. Let me just mark like this. This is a correction. This is a correction. So now I'm just expecting for the market to go. Any retrace, small retracement here, I will buy, then I'll proceed going to the market. Yeah. Any rejection after the market breaks these zones, if it goes up, then it come and reject somewhere here, then I'm going to buy from here. So I'm no longer interested in looking at that zone, because I know that this market is just going. There's no way it's going to come again down. So just delete everything. I already know if price just break this zone, then it's a buy. There's no way I will look behind. It's just a buy. Then the first target is going to be, then you want to see a reaction again here, or just to continue. All these zones, those are my take profit zone. All these on my take profit zone. So, yeah. All these are my take profit zone. Remember, the same way UA30 did, it's the same way Nasdaq is going to do. So, remember, Nasdaq is just buying for now. It's just going to buy. But remember, market will come, we don't know when, but in the next month or weeks to come, it has to come back to this zone here before proceeding to go up again. But we don't know when it starts, but yeah. You see, market is now changing direction. We're supposed to proceed down, but now it's continuing. Like, as we know that Nasdaq is always a bullish market. Yeah, it's always a bullish market. So Yeah, so now it's that time, it's that time, it's that time, it's that time, it's that time for you to bounce up. Yeah, it's that time to bounce up. All these zones are my take profit zone. If I get to in enter somewhere here, to enter somewhere there. Yeah, all these are my, yeah, Nasdaq, it will just also this week is just going to shoot, continue going up. Just going to shoot up. This was a higher high, hello, higher high. Okay. Yeah, so this is a very strong zone. As market's just holding there, but once it breaks that zone, then we are going to say bye bye. Once it breaks that zone, then we are going to say bye bye. Just want to see market to break this zone. Just want to see market to break this zone. If it breaks this zone, I'll say it like, okay, now I'll be very comfortable. And I'll be very confident to buy Nasdaq. Be very comfortable to buy Nasdaq. Yeah. Be very comfortable to buy Nasdaq after it breaks this zone. If it breaks this zone, then it comes to retest. If I just say retest after breaking maybe just a week coming from in, I'm going to buy without any hesitation. Without any hesitation. Yeah, so guys, yeah, guys, you know me, I'm always like I'm always that guy that like encouraging people, like for you guys that you want to really want Forex to work in your life. The way I always tell you guys that this market can change your life and your family life. Understand? So it's not easy in the beginning. I'll always repeat, it's never easy. Forex is never easy in the beginning. But guess what? Once you start becoming a profitable trader, you will forget all this pain, you understand? I was also there, I was there, I was also there, I was there crying. Guys, with time, I'll make a small, a short story of my journey on how I started and like how it took me to be like to have the knowledge I'm having right now to be from a loser to a profitable trader, which it wasn't easy. Yeah, but you know, as a forex trader, you must always be that person that like learning, you understand? Don't be that person that okay, once now you're making money, you stop learning. Forex is all about you learn. If you keep learning, you will like understand, you understand? You will like know a lot of things that because sometimes we are trading, you think that you're really fine, but what you are trading, that's not how you're supposed to approach the market, you understand? So, but the more you start now, you're doing some research, learning from also from other traders, as long as you are learning from people who trade the same style as you trade, you understand? But if you are trading, if you trade in a way that the person that you are trying to follow you or you see how he trade is not the same like yours, don't follow that person because it's just going to mess you around. So all you need, just have a plan, you understand? Just have a plan, trade your plan. Don't avoid these signal groups of jumping from this person to this person. No, the aim here is for you to be dependent, is for you to be independent, is for you to make your own money, is for you to analyze yourself and make your own money. Understand? That is the main aim. It's not for you to jump like a, I don't know, people, or yeah, just like people that they don't know where they are. Understand? As long as all you need, just have a certain goal that you want. Understand? And then money will follow you. For now, if you are a beginner, don't just rush. Like, you want to make money, money. Money will come with time. Once, for now, just invest in the knowledge. Knowledge is power. Knowledge is power. There's nothing comparing to knowledge. I'm telling you, knowledge is power. The rest is nothing. Knowledge is power. Learn first. Spend your money learning. Don't spend your money at being scammed. Like, cause most of people, they just want to make quick money. They don't want to learn. They just want account management, all these funny things, you know. Yeah, that's not good. So all what I can tell you guys, just that, never give up. Forex is real. As long as you have a goal. Remember, if you start, if you, like for some of you that maybe you have started already long time, but you're still losing, remember that at the end of a tunnel, there's a light, you know? So never give up. Even though if people, they're like discouraging you, don't look on them, because me, I was once there, and I'll testify this, Forex is real, bro. So if you're a lady there, and you're just trying, but you can't, just, even if your boyfriend want to leave you, your girlfriend want to leave you, just say it's fine. Yeah, because I was there, I know how this thing works, bro. You are going to lose your relationship because of this Forex thing. Just because you are giving too much attention to it than your girlfriend or than your boyfriend. But remember, if your aim is to be your own boss, and then trust me, you won't care about what your boyfriend or your girlfriend is going to do. Any decision your girlfriend or your boyfriend will take for you, it won't be like a problem, you know, because you are fighting for something. You want to achieve something in life. Yeah, so guys, as I was telling you, for this week, I'll be looking to buy NASDAQ. And last week, I already lost the movement of US 30, but this week, I don't think I'll miss this NASDAQ movement to the upside also. So guys, for me, this is Pinto Forex. I'm going to change my price. It will no longer be 500, because I see that what I teach is really something valuable, which is not worth 500. So now I will see, maybe it's going to be 5,000 up, yeah, or even 10,000, so that I'll just deal with serious people, not with people that they are just there for the sake of, I want to make money while they're not putting in too much work, understand? So for me, I'm doing this thing professional. So yeah. And I won't call anyone like to come for my classes, cause classes, just classes, understand? So for me, all I want is just, if you're following me, is for you to learn, like you at least want to get some knowledge from me, not to be to flex around like, hey, yeah. So guys, even if you are watching this video, please share and subscribe, and just wait once price. If you see price breaks this zone on the 1 hour time frame, just consider that is a buy. Yeah. This is DXY. DXY, it seems like it's gonna drop. It seems like it's gonna drop. Yeah, but first it has to, maybe it's just correcting here, then it's gonna, drop. So, yeah, guys, this is Pinto Forex, and I wish you all the best. Like, have a blessed week. Let it be a profitable week for us this week. Yeah, so guys, see you on the next video next weekend. Yeah, I'm out. I'm out. Stop sharing.